This is TV Ontario, Channel 19 in Toronto, Channel 20 in Sault Ste. Marie.
Quarter to three, no one in the place except you and me. So set them up, Joe. Here's a little story, you.
Hi there, hi there. Welcome back to Magic Shadows. Elwy here, and I happen to be still here at George Brown, but I'm in the bartender's course, if you please. And I'm just learning to mix a Singapore sling. Oh, that's a little devil. Ah, there we go. Now, let me see what I need. Just a little bit of that. Just a bit, not too much. Some of this, I think. You're going to be meeting Robert Godwin, the instructor. But since Robert isn't here just yet, I don't see him around anywhere, I think we'll...
Elwy.
Oh, Robert. what a strange surprise and coincidence. How are you, sir?
Good to meet you.
Well, I've already introduced you. Robert, this Singapore sling, what actually is... goes into it, or what's gone into it here?
Well, it's made, the base is gin, and it's made with lemon juice, grenadine, finally topped off with cherry brandy and soda, the last two things that you put in there.
As a student here, if I were a student, as I'm kind of this week, enjoying myself and learning all about various things in the hospitality genre, bartending today, how could you judge this drink in terms of my proportions as a student, if I were passing an exam on it without tasting it? Or do you taste them all? And how many students can you go through in a day if you do
well,
that?
In fact, the students use colored water, so it's very difficult for me to be able to judge exactly how much of everything they put in there. Just on appearance, more than anything, is what I have to go by. And then I ask them to write down what they put in it, just so that they can show what they used.
Robert Godwin, how many drinks should a bartender, a good bartender, know how to mix?
Well, I insist that they know at least 50 cocktails in here, and we're, in fact, training them to know or try to know 150.
Seriously?
Yeah.
That's quite a roster, isn't it, of
yes,
drinks
it
there? What if a bartender is asked to mix a drink he hasn't been taught here?
Well, invariably you end up asking the customer what's supposed to go in it.
There's nothing wrong with that, then?
No, I wouldn't say so, no.
I guess, you know, it's like life in general, too, and bartending is part of life, that the more secure the bartender, the more he wouldn't mind doing it. But it would be an insecure bartender who wouldn't want to admit.
Yes,
that's rather fascinating. What would be the most popular of the drinks that you drink?
Probably the Singapore Sling or maybe the Screwdriver. Those are two classics that are popular
world
over.
Yes. Oh. And tell me about customer relations now in case, well, I'm thinking of a bartender. How do you train him to deal with a somewhat unruly customer?
Well, in fact, it's very difficult to train anybody to do that. Everybody handles it differently. And, of course, every drunk is different, too. You have the old adage of giving them a cup of coffee, but then you just end up with a wide-awake drunk.
Robert Godwin, thanks for your time. I'm going off. You've got some young students over there I want to talk to.
Okay.
Okay. Please thank you very much, Robert. Right. I'll leave the drink here. Hi, all of you. Just dropping in for my usual. Listen, are all of you planning to become bartenders? What about you, Lisa?
Yep.
Now, Lisa, I'm going to ask you another question. Are you old enough to drink?
No.
But you will be when you graduate.
Yep.
In 10 years. No, no. You'll be graduating when? A couple of years?
No, on the 20th of January.
Really? Isn't that incredible? Just a very short time from now. Peggy, do you want to become a bartender one day?
Yes.
And what kind of an establishment do you want to work in?
Into a very rich establishment.
I'm with you. You remember my face, won't you?
Of course.
If I ever drop in. What has the future got for you, Noah?
I'd like to be a waiter.
You'd like to be? I wish you good fortune, too. This looks very nice indeed. Well, I think it's time we go to our movie, don't you? Okay. Well, ladies and gentlemen, Kevin, the new boy, has really had a rough introduction to Mr. Marango's restaurant, hasn't he? He's discovered that he's working amidst a group of chronic complainers, and each one has an axe to grind, and he's usually grinding it on the person next to him. Here now, day 3 of Arnold Wesker's The Kitchen.